And welcome to another Scriptcase tutorial. Today we're going to be looking at working with files inside of Scriptcase. My name is Nate Carpenter, and I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this tutorial. Scriptcase gives us a lot of functionality for working with files and automates a lot of the process, including uploading the file and saving the files themselves. Today we're going to be looking at three ways that Scriptcase makes this easier for us. First, a single file database upload, so uploading a single file to the database. And then uploading a single file to the server, and lastly, uploading multiple files to a database. I hope this is helpful for you. Let's get started. All right, so we're in the Scriptcase development environment, and I want to show you the database tables that we're going to be using. So I'm going over here to the ER diagram that's available in Scriptcase, and I'm just looking at these two tables. The clients table is the first table we're going to look at, and this is just kind of a basic table that we use to manage clients. And if you look right here, we have this cvitae field right here. That's going to be our document upload form. So that's something our clients could upload their curriculum vitae to if they wanted to, or resume. And then we also have the file and the size. Those are two pieces of information we need for this upload. We also have this files table, which we're going to use for the multi-upload. And we'll use that a little bit later, and we'll come back to it to see how it works. So let's go back here, and I'm going to create first the single file database upload. That was the first item on our list. We're going to do that with a form application. So when users are adding a record to their clients table here, they can upload their cvitae with it. So let's go to new application here. And it's going to be a form application. I'm going to choose the clients table. Name it like that, click create. It's going to be a pretty standard form. Let's take some of the fields that we don't care about off. So we're going to get rid of the password fields and some of those authentication fields. We're not worried about them right now. So let's hit save on this. Let's go ahead and run this and see what it looks like. Just a basic field. And as you can see, Scriptcase already recognized this field, which is a binary field in the database, as an upload field, but it thinks it's an image. So we're going to go to change that. So let's go over to our Scriptcase development environment. Let's go to fields. And see it says image database. We're going to change that to a document. Since it's a curriculum vitae, that's typically a document. So document database is a type. And I'm going to name it vitae like so. Let's display the icon of the file type. And then we need to tell it where the file name is going to be stored in the database. So what field that is, and the file size where that will be stored. So that will be handled automatically by Scriptcase. We just need to tell it where to put it. So we're going to take the name, and we're going to put that in the file field like so. And the file size will be put in the size field. Let's hit save. And then we're going to make it look a little bit nicer. We're going to put this field over on the right here to make it a little bit easier. So we're going to create a block just for that field. So we're going to go to layout, blocks here on the left, create a new block. We're going to call this the vitae block. Click create on that. And we want to display beside it. So we need to tell the previous block, this main block here, that the next one's going to display beside it. So next, beside. And then we want each block to take up half of the screen. So the width will be 50%. And let's hit save on these. And then let's go back up the fields positioning here, and we're going to move our vitae field down into our vitae block, like so. Let's hit save on that. Let's go ahead and run this and see how it works. Okay, so we've got all of our informational fields here, and we've got our vitae block here. So that's all set up, and let's make sure our other fields are in the correct order. So the ID field can be put right there, and then let's move last name up under name like so, email, phone, and we don't need the send email field, so let's take that off. Address, file size, those can be taken off as well, because those will be automatically updated by Scriptcase. There we go, that should make it nice looking. So let's go ahead and run this and see what it looks like. Okay, so we've got our informational fields over here, and then the vitae field over here. So let's go ahead and fill in some information here. Just kind of filling in some dummy data here. And then let's upload a file. So we'll click select file here, and I've just got a test PDF here. And we'll let that upload. It'll take just a couple seconds. Okay, and it's uploaded. So let's click add now. Go ahead and add this record. And it said new record inserted successfully. So let's go ahead and look and see if it's in the database. So let's go in our Scriptcase development environment, and we'll go to database builder so we can see the table, choose our connection here, and choose our clients table, and select data here. And there we go. So we've got our record we just added, and we've got that file right there. That's the file name, and then the size of the file, and then the vitae is actually in that. It's not showing it here because it's a binary field, but there it is. Okay, so that's how you do a database single file upload. So that file is actually stored in the database. But that might be an issue for some larger files to store them in a database. So perhaps you want to store it actually on your server. So that's what we're going to look at next. Let's go back to our home here. And we're going to take that form we just created and copy it. Just going to name it slightly different here. So this one will save an image to the server itself, to the file system of the server. So we're going to edit that form. And we're going to change the fields a little bit. We're not concerned about this vitae anymore. Instead, we're going to upload an image. So let's hit save on that. And we're going to go to fields, and we're going to add a field. Click next on that. And we're going to do an image file. And for the type, we're going to do an image file name. And for the type, we're going to do an image file name. So as you can see, we have the image database, image file name, document database, and document file name. The database ones are obviously going to save it to the database, and the file name ones are going to save it to the file system. So image file name like so. I'm going to call it picture. Like that. And we're going to put this in the same block as the vitae was. But first, let's get this set up. So we've got the height and the width, some different settings here, hide image, name. We can do different things here. But we're going to leave these to the default for right now. Let's go ahead and make sure that this is in the vitae block here. And it is. So let's go ahead and run this and see how it works. Okay, so we've got a record we already created here, and we can just select the file here for the image. I selected a file here, wait for that to upload. Okay, there it is. And as you can see, it's showing the image file name right there. Let's hit save on this. Wait for the process, data modified, and it displays a little thumbnail. And there's the image file name right there. Okay, so now we've looked at how to upload something to the database and to the file system, but these are only single files. So now we're going to look at how to upload multiple files at once to your database. So to do this, we need that other database table, the files table. So let's go ahead and look at our database diagram again. So over here is where we're going to store all of our files that are connected to our clients. What we're going to do is we're going to store a file ID that's automatically generated, and then a user ID, which is going to be tied to our client ID over here. And then here in the binary value, we're going to store the file itself, and then a file name and a file type, just like we had down here. So now let's do this. So we're going to create a form application again. So let's go to New Application. Choose a form application. We're going to use our clients table again, since this is tied to them. Name it like so, and let's click Create. Okay, so we've got our form all created here. Let's go over to our field positioning and let's get these fields set up. So again, we can get rid of these authentication fields here. We can get rid of our vitae. We're not worried about that this time. Get rid of the send email. And let's move last name up to name like that. That'll make it look nice. Let's hit save on that. Okay, now we need to create a field to upload images to. So we're going to go to fields here, create a new field, click next on that, just one new field, and create a block for that. We're going to call it picture, and make sure our spelling is correct. There we go, and this is going to be an image database like before, but in the database this time. And we're going to let it create a new block for that. Let's click Create. Okay, so we've got our image database. We've got some of the same settings here, but you also see we have this multi-upload area here. So this allows us to upload multiple files, but first we need to tell it where it's going to be put. That is this table setting. We're going to put it in our files table, just like we had before. And that's automatically going to give us some other settings to allow us to set the values for the fields in there. So for the file ID, that's going to be auto increment, like so. And we're going to let it do the manual increment, since that's already on the table, to increment it itself. Then the user ID is going to be a foreign key. That's going to be the client ID from this client record. And then the binary value is going to be the upload itself, the file that's uploaded. Then the file name is going to be the file name, like so. And the file type, we're going to leave like that. We're not going to worry about that right now. We could set that programmatically later on. So now that should be set up. Let's make sure that the block is set up correctly. So we're going to set it up kind of like the other one. Let's go to blocks. There's our picture block. We want it to display next to the other one. So we're going to do beside. And then let's split the width 50-50 like before. And we're going to make it look nice, so we're going to put a label on the block. And then we're going to check it so it displays that title. And let's go ahead and run this and see what it looks like. Okay, so as you can see here, we've got our record that we've added before. We've got our picture block over here that we can expand and collapse if we want. We've got a button to add files. And then we also have the start upload button. And that's going to initiate the upload of the files themselves, since this is a secondary table that it's accessing here. So let's go ahead and select a couple files here. So I've got two images here. I'm going to select them both and click open. So as you can see, it's displaying the names pending upload. It doesn't upload them automatically like we saw before, because we need to click the start upload button. So let's click start upload and go ahead and wait for those to upload. Okay, and now it's showing that both of them have uploaded. So now we can hit save on this. And there we go. It's showing our two images that we uploaded with thumbnails, and they should be saved in the files table. And I do want to show you one more thing. So let's click Add Files. Let's add another file here. And as you can see, it's pending upload still. And if we try to hit save, it'll give us a little error message. And this says there's still remaining uploads. That's because we haven't actually told it to start uploading. So we can tell it to upload like that. And then once it finishes uploading, then we can click save. Okay, it uploaded, and then we click save. And now it has them all saved like that. And then if we look at our files table in the database builder, we should see those images there. So let's look at our files table. There's three rows, select data. And there we go. There are our three files like that right there. Okay. So now that's how you upload multiple files using a Scriptcase form to the database. So that's three different ways we looked at: the multiple files, the files to the database, and the files to the file system itself. So I hope this tutorial was helpful for you. I hope it clarified a lot of things of how files work inside of Scriptcase, and I hope you find a lot of uses with this functionality. I'll see you in the next tutorial.